All right, so today we're going to be solving a problem from AMC 8. This particular problem was taken from the 2019 question paper, and it is problem number one on that test. So some of the topics that we're really going to get into by solving this problem are really basic arithmetic. Basic arithmetic. So we're talking about, we're really talking about your four basic operations, you know? Four operations, so basic computation, and also understanding word problems. And the reason why I mention this is because, especially with AMC 8, you really want to understand what they're asking, because a lot of times the mistake people will make is not with their actual calculations, it's with a misunderstanding in the problem. So most of the AMC 8 problems are word problems, and it's really good to know what they're asking and how you can get there. Alright, so talking about our question, let's go over ours. Ike and Mike go into a sandwich shop with a total of $30 to spend. Sandwiches cost $4.50 each, and soft drinks cost $1 each. Ike and Mike plan to buy as many sandwiches as they can and use the remaining money to buy soft drinks. Counting both soft drinks and sandwiches, how many items will they buy? Alright, so let's go ahead and just define some of our clues about this. So first they're saying your total is $30. They're saying how much sandwiches cost is $4.50, and they're saying $1 is the cost of each soft drink. Alright, so I encourage you to go ahead and take a minute, try it on your own, and come back and hit play whenever you're ready. So I'm assuming you've given it a go. Let's get started. So given this information, what I would do is I would go ahead and say, okay, what they're telling us is x times s has to be less than or equal to 30, because they can't go over the amount they spent. But what they're also asking us is they're really saying buy as many sandwiches as they can. So they're really saying, go ahead and say, what is the greatest value of x? What is the greatest value of x that still fits this criteria? Greatest value. All right, so the way I would do this is I don't like dealing with decimals, personally, especially in a competition where I'm racing against the clock. I don't want to work with decimals. So what I would do is I would go ahead and say $4.50 is equal to 9 over 2. So I would go ahead and say, how many times does 9 go into 30? And knowing my times tables, we can easily say 9 times 3 equals 27. And we can see 27 is fairly close to 30, and it is the highest multiple of 9 that is still lower than 30. And knowing this, what we can do is we can say, okay, you're dividing this value by 2. So in order to get the same product, you need to multiply your other value by 2. Multiply it by 2 in order to get the same product. So the way our little equation would play out in that case would be 4.5 times 3 times 2, or 6, is equal to 27. So now that we have this, we can easily say that this is the greatest amount of sandwiches. It works out perfectly for this set of numbers, but in other cases, the way you would have to also verify that that is the same is by saying, can I add 4.5 to 27 and not cross over 30? Is 27 really the greatest multiple I can get? So what I would do is I would go ahead and say 27 plus 4.5. I would add them up, and I would find that that's equal to 31.5, which is indeed greater than 30. So this does not work. We cannot go over that. So we can confidently say that 6 is our number, and that this is the amount of sandwiches. That this is the amount of sandwiches. Sandwiches. All right. Next, let's go on to soft drinks. A very common mistake that people might make here is go ahead and say, oh, great, we have the answer now. All right, and they would go ahead and circle A. Because this number of sandwiches is in the answer choices. And the thing is, with multi-step problems like these, you need to wait and really see what they're asking. And in this case, they're not asking what the amount of sandwiches is. They're asking, counting both soft drinks and sandwiches, how many items will they buy? So we also need to find out the amount of soft drinks. So don't go ahead and just circle A. So once you have the total that they have spent on sandwiches, the total that they spent on sandwiches, you can see how much they have left because they're saying they're going to use the remaining money. So find the amount they have left and see how many soft drinks you can buy with that. The way we can do that is go ahead and say 30, their total money, minus the money they spent on sandwiches, is equal to 3. So 3 must be their remaining money. Once we have that step, we can go ahead here and say that you can buy 3 soft drinks, with this money. And how we can say that is because we know that each soft drink costs $1, and 3 divided by 1 is equal to 3. So now that we have our two separate numbers, we have our soft drink value and our sandwich value, we can add them up to find the total amount of items. So 3 plus 6 is equal to 9, and that would be our final answer. So we can go ahead and say that 9 is the answer to this AMC 8 question, and if we were in this test, we would go ahead and circle D.